हेलो फर्स्ट हैंड स्टूडेंट्स, योर इंग्लिश लेसन नंबर 3, द एडवेंचर्स ऑफ लिटिल एल। एडवेंचर्स मीन्स व्हाट? डेयरिंग एक्सपीरियंस। इन कन्नडा विल टेल साहसा। सो डेयरिंग एक्सपीरियंस दोज पर्सन विल डू, दे आर कॉल्ड एडवेंचर्स। द एडवेंचर्स ऑफ लिटिल एल। दिस एल इज द निक नेम ऑफ थॉमस अल्वा एडिसन। सो द लेसन इज अबाउट थॉमस अल्वा एडिसन। हु वॉज थॉमस अल्वा एडिसन? ही वॉज ए ग्रेट साइंटिस्ट। He was an inventor. So Thomas Alva Edison was born on February 11, 1847 in United States of America. His date of birth is not given in your reader, but you should remember his date of birth. Thomas Alva Edison was a great scientist. He was a great inventor. He was born on February 11, 1847 in United States of America. So his name is Thomas Alva Edison. His nickname is Al. People used to call him Al. His friends, all in his house, his parents used to call him Al. It is a nickname of Thomas Alva Edison. Some children will be having nickname like Bobby, Bunty, like this. Edison also had a nickname, that is Al. So he was a best known inventor in history. He was the youngest of the 7 children of his parents. See, Thomas Alva Edison parents had 7 children. Among 7 children, he was the youngest. He was the smallest, last child. He was the youngest of his 7 children. And everyone called him Al. Al is the, as I just now told, Al is the nickname of Thomas Alva Edison. Young Al was a weak and a fragile. See, this is called fragile. Fragile means what? Fragile means physically weak. It is called fragile. Al was a weak and fragile. He was dull. Because he was weak, his body was weak, so he was dull. Fragile means dull. Fragile child with an unusually large head. His head was big. Unusual means not usually we all have head. His head was big and his body was weak, and at the same time he was dull student in the class. For some years he was not allowed to go to school because of poor health. As he was physically weak, his health was not good. So when health is not good, we cannot attend the school properly. So he was not allowed to go to school because of his poor health. Al was poor at studies. Automatically, when somebody is weak in health, when somebody is not feeling well, his health is not good, means automatically he cannot concentrate on his studies. So he was poor at studies. Once his teacher said in front of his mother that he was addled. Addled means very weak in studies. His mother was a teacher herself. She decided to withdraw Al from school and educate him at home. So one day Thomas Alva Edison's teacher only told his mother that he was not good at studies. So Edison's mother decided that Edison was not allowed to go to school. Instead, what his mother did, his mother decided to educate his son at home only. Next, as a boy, Edison's curiosity and daring led him into unusual adventures. See, Edison actually, inside his brain was very extraordinary. His interest, curiosity means interest. His interest was to do adventures, new things. He wanted to do new things. So at the age of 6, he went missing one day. After an anxious search, his father found him sitting in a nest. Nest means a small house. Birds, they make nest, no? With the help of grass. That is called nest. Hut. You can sing that hut, gudisalu. He had made in the barn. See, in his house, garden only, he made a small house with the help of grass. The nest was filled with eggs and hen eggs he had collected. Edison had noted the way of goose hatched her eggs by sitting on them, and he wanted to try it himself. So that is called adventure. He wanted to do some new thing. What he observed, that he observed that hens lay eggs and hatch eggs. So he decided to do that. He wanted to hatch the eggs. That is why you can see in this picture, he is Edison, Thomas Alva Edison. When he was a child, he began to think that he wanted to hatch the eggs. So he kept eggs here down, and he is sitting on the egg, and he is trying to hatch the eggs as hens do. Though Edison did not attend school regularly, he used to read every book in his reach. Even though Edison did not go to school, he was educated in the house only by his mother. So his mother, she gave many books to Edison to read. So he began to read many books. His parents were educated and refined people with a good library at home. His mother made a library at home. She kept many books at home. Edison began to read those books. He read voraciously, mostly books on history and science. He was very interested, curious about history and science. He began to read those books only on history and science. He even tried reading scientific books that were beyond the grasp of a child. See, he was around 10 years old. At the 10 years old only, when he was a small child, he began to read many scientific books, science magazines, and he tried those experiments by his own. In the cellar of his home, cellar means a house which is under the ground. In the cellar of his home, see, this is a house, you think, this is a house. Under the ground, he made a small house, a nest. That is called cellar, under the ground, a small room under the ground. It is called cellar. So in the cellar of his home, Edison set up a small laboratory when he was 10 years old. So when he was 10 years old only, he read science magazines, and whatever he read in the magazine, he began to come and do experiments. Every time he read about an experiment in a science book, he would try it in his laboratory. See, this is his laboratory. He is Edison. See, you can see many chemicals are kept in the shelves in his room, which is under the ground. That is called cellar. See, he had collected around 200 bottles of chemicals and arranged them carefully on shelves of his cellar lab. All of them were labeled poison so that no one else would handle or disturb them. See, he collected around 200 chemicals he collected, and he kept in the bottle in the shelf carefully. He protected them, and he labeled those bottles with the name called poison. Poison means visha. If somebody see that, they will not touch. So he did not want to disturb his experiments. So the experiments consumed the boy's pocket money rapidly. So from where did he brought these chemicals? Who gave money to Edison? His parents did not give money to Edison to bring these chemicals. What he did, soon he started working as a newsboy. Newsboy means a small children selling newspapers. They come to house and put newspapers, as we see daily morning 6:30. They come to our house and throw newspapers and go. So he worked as a newsboy. He used to sell newspapers. Though his parents objected to this. His parents were not interested to do such kind of work. But he did not care, because he wanted to do experiments. He wanted to bring chemicals. From where did he got money? He got money by selling the newspapers. Edison pointed out that as a newsboy he could earn all the money he needed for his experiments. What he thought? He worked as a newsboy. Whatever money he got from by selling newspaper, he brought the chemicals and did experiments by reading the science magazines. Besides, he could read newspapers and magazines for free. He only selling newspapers, so he used to make the time free time, and early morning only before 5 o'clock, 5:30, he used to read the newspaper. First he only used to read the newspaper, and afterwards he used to go by cycle and sell the newspapers. House to house he used to go and give the newspaper, and whatever money he got from that, he used to bring the chemicals and do experiments. He was soon selling periodics on a local train that traveled between Port Huron, where he lived. He lived in the city called Port Huron. It is a name of a place where he lived, Port Huron. So in the train also he began to sell the newspapers and Detroit a business center. Many people saw his hard work and they gave a room in the train only. This train had a disused smoking compartment which was given to Edison to keep his papers. So in the train only he got a compartment, a bogey, a room where he used to keep his newspapers. He kept his papers there, but besides that he also transferred his laboratory from the cellar and set it up on the train. At the age of 14, Edison became a striking example of overcoming hardships to pursue knowledge. So to gain knowledge, he struggled a lot. At the age of 14 only, he began to work as a labor, as a newsboy. He sold the newspapers, and whatever money he got from that, he did not waste by eating sweets, gobi manchur and all. What he did? He bought these chemicals and kept in his laboratory, and he began to do many experiments. That was his courage. So people praised him at the age of 14 only, at the small age, so much of struggle he is doing for knowledge. Understood? So today we'll stop here. Remaining, the lesson is not completed. Half we have done. The remaining will continue in the next class. Till then, what you have to do? You have to read this lesson, a very beautiful lesson, The Adventures of Little Al. Read this lesson slowly in your house and try to understand this explanation, what I have done. Understood? We'll continue this lesson in the next class. So he is Edison, his laboratory is there. Understood? So this is the man who helped him in the train. He gave a compartment in the train only where he kept all his chemicals and newspapers in this compartment. So he did many experiments. We'll continue this lesson in the next class.